Oh. Hmm. This hot cocoa tastes like warm water with a brown crayon dipped in it. Hmm. I'm gonna have to put another crayon in it. Well, hello there, everyone. Welcome to Peanut Sketch School. My name's Noel, and I'm gonna be your art teacher here in just a moment. I'm gonna show you how to draw the most lovable little sister that ever graced the Sunday Funnies, Sally Brown. Now, before we get started, just a few things I'd like to go over with you. The beauty of these videos, you get to work at your own pace. If something during the video confuses you, or if you think for any reason I'm going too fast, you can always hit pause, or you can back up and watch a step again in case you missed one. This gives you the chance to work at your own pace. A lot of advantages here. Also, I highly recommend you get some other people to come together and draw with you. When we do these sketch schools at the parks, literally the best part of this is at the end of the class, we all hold up our drawings and show each other what we did. It's always fun seeing what other people come up with. All right, now on to the art supplies we're gonna need. For today's art supplies, all you need is a few things you got laying around your house. First, an ordinary pencil. I recommend a nice soft lead, like a number 2. But if you got markers, crayons, that'll work just fine too. And the other thing you're gonna need is a piece of paper. What you won't need is an eraser, because we're doing what's called a rough sketch. I'm gonna go into that a little bit more in just a moment. All right, everybody, pour yourself something good to drink and get ready to draw. Pencils up. It's officially cartoon time. All right, comic strip fans, how to draw Sally, step number 1. In the middle of your paper, lightly, and that's the key word to sketching, keep it light. Lightly sketch in a circle that's about as big as an orange. Now I have a few drawing tips. Like I said, keep it light, but here's the biggest one. You're not writing. When you write, you only use your wrist and make little itty bitty chipping strokes to make letters and numbers. Broader strokes are needed to build the shape. This is more like sculpting. In fact, if you look at what I'm doing here, all I'm doing is drawing curved lines, big ones, every time I put the pencil on the page. And then I'm blending these together with more curved lines to sculpt and shape it out. Again, the thing that really helps is keeping it light. And this takes practice. Don't get frustrated if you don't get it right the first time. All right, so we got something nice and round on our page. Let's turn it into a cute little sister. First thing we're gonna do, and this is gonna help us a lot, I'm gonna add some guidelines. From the top of her head, which is here, to the bottom, which is down here, very lightly, I'm gonna divide this in half. This line tells me this is the front center side of this form. Little Sally's looking straight out at you guys in the audience. I'm also gonna go right to left with another guideline. Basically what we're doing here, gang, we're putting a big old plus sign on this circle. This does two things. One, it shows us where the center of our main shape is. And two, it gives us four smaller spaces to work in instead of one big one. We got a better shot at getting stuff where we want it. All right, by the way, this is totally not gonna get any harder, I promise. First feature we're gonna draw is her nose. Now this is a little letter C. Depending on which way you point this, that's where she's gonna look. I'm gonna have my Sally looking that way. Now like I said, her nose sits right here in the middle. Nice round letter C. Think cute the entire time you draw Sally. In fact, if you have a little sister, think about your own little sister. Or if you are a little sister, think of some of the mischief you've gotten in because you're a little sister. Oh, big brother, will you help me with my book report? There we go, a cute little nose. Now the next step, we're gonna draw some ears. And this is a little trick. On all the Peanuts characters, they sit in the same spot. The bottom of the nose will always line up with the top of the ears. That's what this guideline is gonna help us do. So find the bottom of her nose, go right over here, and snap on another C curve. Right there. This goes outside the main circle. Think of this like a little handle on a coffee cup. Whoop. I'm over here, let's do the same on this side. Nice and round. So right about now, we should have a gumball with a cute nose and two little ears. Don't worry, it's gonna look like Sally soon, I promise. Now the next step is to wake her up. This is a trick on the Peanuts characters too. Their eyes sit in the same spot on each one of them. Their eyes will always go just below the top of the nose and on either side of it. Here and here. Now the trick here is, gang, keep these eyes close to the nose. You don't want them above the nose or off to the side. Just start looking more grown up. And another little tip, these are small shapes. Actually, they're small circles. They're not just dots. That's what I'm trying to say. Really spend a little time making this a nice round shape here. That way your viewer will notice this first when they look at your sketch of Sally and they'll look her right in the eye. They're more likely to make a connection with your cartoon character if you can get them to look them in the eye. Think of her as a little actor in your comic strip panel. Now, directly above the eyes, we're gonna add her eyebrows. The trick here with eyebrows, they can bend up, that'll make her look surprised, or they could bend in and she'll look grumpy and angry. The trick is they always need to be above the eye. If they drift off to the side, well, they'll start to look more like forehead wrinkles. I'm gonna give her this perked up. She always has this, what are the other kids up to, kind of an attitude. She always wants to be included. That's what happens when you're not so very big. So we got a cuter looking little gumball here. Now, this next step is really gonna make this look like Sally. We're gonna put her hair on. Now to draw the hair, I'm gonna break it down into some basic shapes and then we're gonna add some detail. The main part of her hair is this big poof of hair right here. Those are her curls. And then on the sides, her hair sticks out. Essentially, these are gonna be triangles. We'll start with this circle first. Now remember at the beginning of the lesson how I asked you to draw real light and sketchy? Well, let's get sketchy again, because we're drawing a new shape. We're not adding detail here like we were on the face. This starts inside the circle, just sits right on it. In fact, at this point, she should start looking a little bit like a snowman with a belly button. Here we go, nice and round. Looks kind of weird for a moment, but trust me, soon it'll look like hair. It's all in the details, people. Now for where the hair sticks out. I'm gonna start on either side, right where each circle's touching, here and here. On either side, I'm just gonna bring a curving line right off of here. Same on this side. If there's a trick to this at all, gang, you don't want these lines straight, because we don't want our hair to end up looking like horns. Keep everything rounded. Sharp edges make characters look harsh. They draw those on cartoon villains a lot. Now for the rest of the hair, I'm gonna close this with a stretched out letter S. This is a curve and a curve. That's all an S is, two curves facing different directions. It starts at the end of this line and it will end just below her ear. We'll do this one first. Stretchy S. Curve, whew. Then you curve the other way, whew. Right underneath that ear there, people. Now the first line that you put down may or may not be the one that you want to keep. So again, stay sketchy. A lot of learning to draw is learning that you're not writing. When we write, we always want to press down real dark and heavy to make a definite mark. Drawing is about building and finding these shapes as we go. So a much lighter touch is needed. Stay sketchy. Here we go. Should look kind of like a butterfly, but at a glance, it's starting to take on the shape of Sally Brown. Now for the details. Now this is the fun one. In fact, this is my favorite part of drawing little Sally. We're gonna draw her curls. Starting in the center here, and Charles Schultz drew this little gal, he just filled this up with a bunch of loopy loops with his pen. Here's how we're gonna do it. Boop. Put a little dot right in the middle of your circle. And starting from that point, let's just fill this thing up with a bunch of little flower petals. You can get some big ones, get little small ones, they can overlap. Draw these as many or as few as you like. You literally get to design Sally's hairstyle today before she goes to school. I love this character. She says a lot of awkward things in class, pointing out several injustices. In fact, little Sally's the only character I've ever seen ask Santa Claus for 10s and 20s. Now for the detail on the sides, we'll take care of this side first. Now whichever side her nose is pointing at, Charles Schultz would always draw these two curved lines, one, two, coming right off of the head shape into the hair, facing that way. And then on this side, you would bring two curves off of the hair. These kind of bunch up. One, two. There we go. Now, if you're gonna color this little gal in with your crayons, she has blonde hair. Last step before we get that cute mouth on there, I am gonna take just a moment here, people, and I am gonna darken in the side of the circle. Here we go. The thing I want you to notice as I'm doing this, I'm not writing one line, but instead I am building a line by gently sketching around the shape. Again, think like you're sculpting. You're refining the side of your shape here. Now, the comic strip Peanuts debuted way back in the year 1950, and it ran all the way through the year 2000. Little Sally Brown here did not debut with the comic strip Peanuts. She showed up in the year 1959, and she originally debuted in the strip as a little baby. She didn't have this full head of hair. She only had one itty-bitty hair on top with a little bow. She also would have a binky in her mouth quite frequently. She still kind of has a baby face if you look at her. All right, and now for the smile. I like to give Sally a very small little thin smile here. This gives her kind of that coy, mischievous nature. If you want to give her a bigger smile, you're more than welcome to. Here's where the smile goes on this little gal. This is true on all Peanuts characters. I'm going to give myself one more quick guideline. The smile line always lines up perfectly with the bottom of the ears. Nose hits the top, that mouth, boop, hits the bottom. And I'm gonna make her mouth just as wide as the eyes are. Here and here. If you wanna give her a bigger smile, you can even draw an oval, and give her an open mouth like she's yelling at Linus. There's no great pumpkin! I missed tricks or treats! I always liked the way she called it, tricks or treats. Now for the smile to start with, I'm gonna draw these little C curves. These are creases that form when your mouth smiles and pushes up against your cheeks. In fact, they're almost like eyebrows for the mouth. And then I'm just gonna connect this with a round curve. Very mischievous. She's looking at her sweet baboo. That's what she calls Linus. He doesn't like that very much. He's so handsome. And to finish this, I'm gonna draw her collar and her neck. Never like to just draw a head floating there. I think that looks weird, man. Now the neck is just a tube. For us, this is two straight lines. It goes right below the nose. All the Peanuts characters have this in common, this trait. They have a big head and a skinny neck. Here we go. Two straight lines, just as wide as the nose. And I'm gonna close this off with a curve. This is the top of her dress. Sometimes she wears a sweater. Sometimes she wears a little dress. We're gonna draw her collar on her dress today. She's getting a little fancy. She's on the interwebs for Pete's sake. All right, then I'm gonna add two curves on here. This is the collar. Rounded little flaps of cloth. She wears a little pink dress. Sometimes it has little dots on it. Hey, wait a minute, comic strip fans. We just did this. We just drew a picture of Sally. There's one last thing you gotta do. Sign your name next to that. You just drew the world's most famous comic strip little sister, Sally Brown. Ta-da! Man, that sure was fun. I really love drawing Sally. That hair is a blast. Well, thanks for drawing with me. And I advise all of you to keep practicing. The more you practice, the better you'll get. Who knows? Maybe someday you'll even start your own comic strip, and I'll see you in the Sunday Funnies. Till next time, stay sketchy.